Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna. Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwaraha, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Life is a journey from the virtual reality to actual reality, and the journey from actual reality to virtual reality. So there are two realities. One is actual, second is virtual. Now you being the students of computer, you are all expert in virtual reality, and I am expert in actual reality. So let us come together and see what I can learn from you and what you can learn from me. Life is a series of learning experiences. If we do not learn from the experiences of our life, then we are dumb. We are good for nothing. But as you are extremely intelligent, that is what I was told before coming here, your teacher told me, Swamiji, today you are going to face challenges. So I already started missing heartbeats. Now let us learn. And we have been doing it, but we are not aware that we are learning, and that is how we grow wise. Now let us take few examples that we can learn from our experiences. You don't have to open any book of Gita, Upanishad, no. Our life is the ultimate book from which we can learn. And if a person cannot learn from his or her life, even God cannot teach him. See? One example I'll give you. You must have seen there are people who are very good in music. And there are people who are born Aurangzeb, like me. I have no music in me. So, those who do not have music in them, you cannot teach them the talam, the rhythm. Rhythm cannot be taught. You have to have it in you. And this I learned once I was having some function. So, they were singing. And there was one person sitting next to me. And it was such a melodious, beautifully going on. This person sitting next to me, he was also clapping. But his clapping was perfectly wrong. So I said, hey, don't do like that. He said, okay. Again, he will clap exactly at the wrong time. I said, how perfect you are in doing the wrong things. He said, no, I am doing all right. This rhythm cannot be taught. You have to have in you. Now apply the same principle everywhere. Learn. Now first learning. Do we have a choice that we can live yesterday or we can live tomorrow or we can live today? Do we have a choice? Yes or no? Are you all feeling shy? Please know our head is heavier than the tongue, is it not? If you don't believe, cut your tongue and weigh and see. So if you have to say yes. So do we have a choice to live yesterday, today or tomorrow?
No.
Good. My prayers are answered by you all. Relax, man. There is nothing to be serious about in life. Serious is a virtual reality. Relax is the actual reality. See? So, this is the first thing we learn. We cannot live yesterday, we cannot live tomorrow. We have to live today. See? Now, is it not easier to follow that which is natural? See? Now take an example. Suppose I tell you, about 239 days before, what did you eat for your evening tea? 239 days, you keep on calculating. You are lost. Second, where will you be on 780th day from now onward? Come on, this is too much. The moment you go away from yourself, you are lost in virtual reality. And if I ask you, what are you now? No tension, no worries. See? This ability to remain in the actual reality is the journey of life. Instead of this, we get lost in the virtual reality. Now, what is the virtual reality? It is useful, but it is not real. Because something is useful doesn't mean it is real. See? As a child, I used to have big problems. The problem used to be unlike a child. Funny problem. I always used to sit very seriously and think how they must have drawn the longitudes and latitudes on the globe. I used to think about it. Then as a child I will start thinking, I think they must have taken a very big brush, huge one, and they must have gone with the helicopter and the line is drawn. And I used to be very happy, oh good. But again, no man, because the globe is moving and I am in one place, so it will become a spiral, it won't be straight. Oh God, gone again. Again worries. So much of hours I'll spend in this. Now these longitudes and latitudes, do they exist? But are they not useful? Because something is useful does not mean it is real. See friends, how simple it is. Sunrise and sunset is useful, is it not? Sunrise is useful to decide, I can sleep for another half an hour. Is it not? Sunset is useful, come on, I can see one more movie and then go to sleep. Useful. But does it mean that there is sunset and there is sunrise? Then what is that experience? It is the movement of the earth which is superimposed on the sun, is it not? But because of that, if we start imagining that the sunset and sunrise is right, then we are lost in the virtual reality. See, friends. And once we understand the difference between virtual reality and actual reality, life is a fun. This is the fundamental of life. You know how this word is formed? When your fundamentals of life are clear, life is a fun. Fundamental. And if your fundamentals are not clear, life is mental. And such mental people are miserable in this world, and they distribute their miseries freely to anybody who goes near them. See? And such virtual reality victims are, more of them are elderly people than youngsters like you. See? In one place they told me, Swamiji, please tell about our youth, they are not doing something good. I said, look here, don't blame my youth. Youth is the best. They are not useless. They are useless. Discover, create potentiality in them. See, friends, what is essential is, are we living in the actual world or the virtual world? Now see, there was a girl, she did her architect, and she was teaching in a college in Bombay. This happened. A Kannadiga girl, very sweet, very beautiful, very intelligent, rare combination. All these things, all these combinations are virtual, not actual. And she was in love with one boy of her career only, same field, from Delhi. He was a Punjabi. And their engagement ceremony was held in Bombay. So he came all the way from Delhi. A nice function was arranged. And you know that whatever they do, I do not know, I have never done. You are more expert than me. So whatever has to be done, they have done. And thereafter, he went back to Delhi. And from there, he wrote to his fiancée, "Thank you very much for introducing me to your girlfriend. I liked her so much. We liked each other. Therefore, please consider our engagement cancelled and do come for our wedding." When this happened, be attentive, when this happened, that girl was totally nonplussed. She reverted back to the age of 5. Everything is lost for her. And she has to lose the job. She could not teach anything, looking blank. So naturally the parents are worried. Now what to do with this girl, what to do? So whenever people have problem, they come to us. We are the problem dump. So the parents give, "Swamiji, this is what happened, what should I do?" I said, "Do you want me to get married with her?" "Okay." No, not like that. See? Not like that. I said, "You know, you go away, let me talk to her." Then I called her, she was sitting. I said, "I tell you, what's your name?" And she started talking, 28 years girl, started talking like this. "My name is Kalpana." Can you imagine? Then I asked, "What did you study?" "I studied English, I studied maths, I studied Punjabi." She didn't know Punjabi. But that boy to whom she was associating has created such an impact on her that she lost all her cool. See? Because it was a tremendous trauma on her mind. She has already made a virtual reality out of her. Out of her, that she is going to be married to him, then she will move over there, then she will have a beautiful house, then she will have an intelligent husband. This is another illusion. There was one boy, his father was watering the garden. So he was busy, the boy came, about 8 years old or so. "Dad, I want to be an intelligent husband." So dad looked at him, didn't reply, and continued his work. Again he came, "Come on dad, you don't tell me, I want to be an intelligent husband." Again the dad looked at the child with a sympathy. Thereafter, again the child came, held that hose pipe from his hand. "Come on dad, you have to tell me. I want to become an intelligent husband. I don't want to listen from my wife like mama tells you, you are dumb. I don't want to be labeled as dumb by my wife. I want to be an intelligent. Tell me how to become an intelligent husband." So the father said, "Look here, there is no species called as intelligent husband. Because intelligent people never become husband. So far you are intelligent. After your college is over, then we will see who are you. See, friends. So she had that dream that it will be such and such, only living in a virtual reality. And when the bubble of this virtual reality got punctured, she lost herself. My dear friends, please remember, we all are living in this virtual reality. And to live in the virtual reality, we have to learn a Mahamantra. A very simple Mahamantra. That mantra is ability to say no and the courage to listen no from life. Those who cannot deny, they will be crushed in this world. See, friend, you have the ability. Normally what happens, you know, elderly people, they will be eating a lot like a buffalo, and then they are called as Mahatma. You know the meaning of Mahatma? Mahan asti atma udaram yasya sa Mahatma. The one who has got a pot belly is called as a Mahatma. Huge structure. And such people always will say, actually, I don't want, you know, but you know, people compel, so I have to eat. Are you a furniture or what? Anybody can put you anywhere. Have the courage to deny without regrets, without any guilt. Have that courage. If you don't have, you will be washed away in this world. See, friends. This is how the various habits are developed. Smoking, drinking, drugs. How it comes? Peer pressure. You should put pressure on them. You should not get pressurized. But because we are weaklings, weaklings cannot grow in a desert. They want all the time some support. A virtual reality is that aspect of our life which is not real. See, friends. Therefore, when we are leading our life, we have to remain aware at this moment who is functional. Whether it is the virtual reality that is functional or the actual reality that is functional. Be very attentive. When I say, I am old, here the meaning of the word I is body. When I say, I am hungry, here the meaning of the word I is pranamay kosh. When I say I am hurt, I am unhappy, the meaning is I means the mind. When I say I am a successful man, self-made man, like amoeba, binary fission, I am born. Self-made man. That is the intellect, I. And not only that, then, I am a husband, I am wife, I am brother, I am father, I am mother, I am in-law, I am outlaw. How many inside? Are we one or we are a crowd? Think. And wherever there is a crowd, there is a noise. And that noise we all experience inside. That is why we keep on talking to ourselves incessantly, continuously talking. Watch this. In the buses, on airports, anywhere you watch, somebody standing, he is not standing cool. Now why is he doing this funny thing? Because he is talking to himself. And what do we talk? Be attentive. We imagine a problem and then we give imaginary solution and that problem never comes. I'll tell you one experience. I was going from New Zealand to Australia and my friend who is an Australian citizen, So, when we are going through immigration, there was one person who had exchange of very hot arguments with one of the immigration officer. And because of that, the whole atmosphere was very tense. Immediately the police came with the guns and took that person out. So everybody was shivering. I don't know what is going to happen, what is going to happen. And my friend was with me. He was holding my hand so tightly. I said, you know, my blood circulation has stopped. Leave it. And then he said, you know, Swamiji, you have got all the papers. You have got return ticket. Your visa is valid. Everything is okay, na? I said, why are you worried? He said, no, see, let us pray to the Lord. We don't go to the same immigration officer. He's already angry. And he was so tense. And God's will, we have to go only to that immigration officer. So he was holding my hand. Swamiji, I said, come on, yeah, relax. Now you don't understand. I said, okay, never mind. We went. He did not ask one single question. He took my passport, put the stamp, have a good day. My friend said, Swamiji, what happened? Tension. We try to solve the non-existing problems. This is falling in the purview of virtual reality. We go in the future, which never exists. Or we go in the past, and all the time bring the dead past. Anything which is dead stinks. See why the old people are not accepted among you, the youngsters? You all must be the victims of your vigilance officers at home. See? All the oldies at home, they are vigilance officers. They have nothing to do. So whole day they are sitting. Who has come? Who has gone? Why he is standing near the window all the time? What is the reason? Immediately inquiry said, daughter-in-law, that boy I am seeing last few days, he is either standing near the window or he is looking at the fan. What is wrong with him? Has he not seen the fan? Is there something wrong? Because they have nothing to do. So they get into everybody's life. And then, suppose you ask, Dad, I want to have a new pair of shoes. Immediately, your dad or grandfather will bring. In 1927, when we were going to school and college, we never used to have shoes. And you people want so many shoes. Only you have got two legs. Why so many shoes? Thank God you have got two legs. If you have got more legs, how many shoes will you buy? See? In one Tamil house I have seen this. And I went, the moment I entered, there was some tension inside. I could smell that tension. So, I said, hey kiddies, where are you? Both of them were engineering students. So, I said, hey, why don't you sit with me? Okay, Swamiji. Then I asked him, I said, do you know recently, one new gene has come in the market. Like, you know, the ladies have got the golden thing, they call it jari, like that the jeans have come with a design. Have you not bought it? So both of them looked at the father. Even Swamiji knows latest fashion and you are outdated. And then I said, come on, why don't you get them new things? So the children started, Swamiji, whenever we ask anything to our dad, the standard dialogue we have by heart right from childhood. How many shoes you want? When we were children, we used to go to school without shoes. How many pants you want? When we were children, don't tell further. We never used to buy new things. We used to get inherited from the first son. So first, second, third, fourth, fifth. And when the pant is no more able to be put on, then it was given to a beggar, never thrown. That was our life. And these days the children are asking so many things. When the father said like that, I said, now, my dear boy, you say now something. I was enjoying, you know. Don't become serious in life. Put them together to fight and watch from a distance. That is what I do wherever I go. Free entertainment. You don't have to start your TV for seeing the cartoon show. This is a mega cartoon show going on. So, I asked the son, now what is your defense? He said, Dad, your father was damn poor, could not get anything. My dad is rich, why are you jealous? Friends, don't go in the past. It never exists. Don't go on worrying about the future. I don't know what is going to happen. If you don't know, relax. If you know, be prepared. See, when you are not busy, when you are not occupied, you either go in the past or you go in the future. Therefore, my friends, this journey of life from the virtual to the actual is, keep yourself occupied 24/7. Not a single moment of our life should remain unaccounted. 365 days must be accounted. There is no holiday. Every day is a holiday. Provided we learn this beautiful way of life, and that is, don't take life too seriously. When you are serious, you are entering the virtual reality. When you are relaxed, you are the actual reality. See? The husband and the wife, they become serious about each other. And therefore, they are all the time tense. And ultimately, both husband is a virtual reality, wife is a virtual reality. Behind them is the man and the woman. Now be attentive. Man is actual reality, the husband is a virtual reality. By birth, I am a man. After marriage, I have become a husband. So it is becoming, it is not being. Think. And then how many virtual realities we impose on ourselves? So I became a son, I become a husband, I become a father, I become a father-in-law, I become a son-in-law. So many. And all of them are miserable, but the man is never miserable. So who is miserable? This virtual reality. Once in Germany, we had a very beautiful retreat for 3-4 days. After the second day, one German lady asked me this question. Swamiji, you should have come in my life 25 years before. I said, even then I would not have married you. Next. No. Not that. I would not have divorced 3 times. Now I know where I had gone wrong. But it is too early for the next marriage. So what should I do? I said, now, 4th time you get married, decide not to divorce. So simple. After that was over, I said, now I want to increase my general knowledge. Please help me. Because my spiritual practice is learn from every experience of life. That is all. Every experience is our guru. Every experience is our teacher if we are intelligent enough to learn. See? Like when the apple fell, if you and me were there along with Newton, what would you have done? Come on, yaar, take it. See? We would never have thought anything else. Because we are paid to think only about eating, nothing else. See? Learn from the experience. So, I ask her, now let us try to understand what I want to know from you. When you got married for the first time, for our understanding, let us make equations. You were wife 1, W1. And your husband was husband 1, H1. So this was the first pair, W1, H1. Is it not? He said, yes. Then you got married second time, W2, H2. Correct? Yes. Third time, W3, H3. Now my question is, W1 is equal to W2 is equal to W3 is equal to what? When you got divorced for the first time, where you, the wife, has gone? See, if you go in the Western world, you will come to know there. They very coolly introduce, Swamiji, she is my ex-wife and this is her present husband. See, no problem, living in the utter present. So my question was, where that wife, 1, 2, 3, where they have gone? You know, this question is like what? Once somebody was driving me to the airport and I didn't know that person. So I said, sir, I don't know you, please introduce yourself. He said, Swamiji, I am a professor in the Sydney University and I am head of the Department of Computer Sciences. I said, good, my big problem will be solved by you now. I said, what is your problem? I said, my problem is, when we delete the data, where does it go? This is my big problem. Because if there is something lying on the dining table, the leftover food are here. So when we clean it, it comes in your plate, you can throw. But if you are in a hotel, don't take it in a plate, spread it universally. In the same manner, when we delete the data from our laptop, the laptop doesn't become light. We have deleted something. Where it has gone? And if your hard disk, suppose it is 2 TB hard disk, when you bought, let us say the weight was 500 grams, and when you fill the whole 2 TB, will the weight increase? No. So where is that data? It is existing in its non-existence. If it is really existing, that object should become heavy. When you delete, it should become light. But it doesn't happen. Is it not the same case when I become husband? Do I become heavy? When I divorce, do I become light? Then what has happened? Nothing has happened. But who is miserable? It is the husband who is miserable and never the man. It is the mother-in-law, daughter-in-law, they are miserable, never the woman. See? In one of my lives, I have taken many lives, in one of my life, I was a girl. And in that life, I got married to somebody. And as a universal phenomena, my in-laws were terrible. The mother-in-law and the father-in-law, horrible people. Because, you know, this is a technique Americans have learned from India. You know that? This is a marketing technique. Buy one mattress and take 2 pillows free. In the same manner, get married to a boy and get in-laws free. Anything which comes to you free is unwanted inventory which you want to get rid of. This is how I also got my in-laws in my marriage as a dowry gift. And they were so problematic. I was all the time thinking, what to do with these people? I don't know what to do. And that was the only contemplation going on. One day, the wisdom dawned on me and I said, come on, these people, the father-in-law, mother-in-law, they came in my life because I got married to this man. Then I decided I divorced from him. The moment I divorce from him, tell me what I have to do to get rid of the in-laws? Nothing. Apply this principle. We all have to play various roles in life. Roles are not real. You are real. So when you are in front of your father, as a son, behave properly, lead your life as required. See? If you are in front of your son, hide your purse. If you are in front of your wife, never open your mouth. You will be successful virtually and happy actually. See, friends, I had a friend, he is retired now, a brigadier. In Bangalore it happened. So when I went to his house, he was not there, his wife received me, and we were sitting, and at very moment, after 10-15 minutes, he came also. Brigadier means tak, 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 he came. And when he came, he said, "Hey, did you give my friend everything?" Immediately she said, "Look here, you are not in the office." "No, darling, I don't mean that." Immediately everything changed. In the office, roaring like a lion. And in front of the wife, meow, meow. He will be successful both in the office and at the home. And the one who is performing his role of the virtual reality perfectly well, he has a perfect balance in the virtual world of relative existence and in the actual experience of divine bliss. This ability to negotiate through the turmoils of life is the real life lived properly. See, friends, one day one husband came to me and he was very frustrated. "So, Amini, please help me." I said, "I don't give money to anybody. That is my rule. I accept. I don't give. You must be receiving from the banks, they call. Sir, we have got this scheme for giving loan, that scheme for giving loan." So one day, some bank girl called me. "Excuse me, are you Mr. So-and-so?" I said, "Yes." "There is a new scheme. The last car, when did you buy? Now we will take that car back and we give you loan for the next new car." So they started. I said, "You have called me at the right time. I was just thinking about money. Thank you for your calling. But listen, before you talk, you listen to me. I have got certain principles in my life. I receive only donations. No loans." Immediately she put down the phone. Nothing to talk. See? So this husband came and he said, "I'm so miserable because of my wife. How to handle the problem?" I told him, "By cool thinking. There's no other solution. Be attentive. All the problems are born because of wrong thinking. All problems are sorted out by right thinking. You correct your thinking process and you'll be happy." So to that miserable husband, I told, I said, "Let us think. Sit down," he said. Totally frustrated. I said, "Okay, now you answer my question, don't argue." He said, "Okay." I said, "Tell me, husband is a common noun or a proper noun?" "Swami, do you think I am in a school?" I said, "See, you are arguing. You answer my questions. Husband is a common noun or a proper noun?" He said, "Of course it is a common noun. Common noun is what? It is common for everyone." "Yes. Every husband in this world is miserable. If you are miserable, what is new in that? Ask something else." "Do you mean?" I say, "Yes. You know only one husband that you are. I know millions of them because all of them come and pour their problems on my feet." See, friends, just change your thinking. Are you husband 24/7? No. When you are in front of your wife, behave like a husband, very obedient. When she is talking, you should not talk. And when she is keeping quiet, you should also keep quiet. Life will be beautiful. See, friends, but we take life so seriously. And in this manner, what is required is keep yourself busy, busy, busy. Then you will neither go in the past nor will you go in the future. And when you start remaining naturally in the present, you will be all the time cheerful, happy, and see the whole world is a mega cartoon show. And when you see the cartoons, do you become serious? No. Cartoons are meant for enjoying. See, friends. Therefore, never become serious. If a place is there where you have to be serious, pretend you are serious. But you don't have to be serious. One day, one old man in Bombay, that time I was pretty young, he told me, Swamiji, we have to go to my friend's place. He died this morning. So please come with me. And we are such a key, it can fit to any lock. When somebody dies, we go. When somebody is born, we go. When somebody doesn't die, then also we go. Swamiji, do something. Everywhere. So I went there. The dead body was lying there. And then according to the tradition, everybody was taking flower, offering on the dead body. When he was alive, nobody would even talk to him. But now everybody is doing all these things. Then did pradakshina. I also did what they were doing. Just follow. And then I was sitting with a swollen face. He said, Swamiji, please talk something on Gita. I said, he is not listening. You don't want to listen. Talk for whom? To the dead man. And when you are alive, you don't want to listen. And you ask the dead man to listen. Okay, keep quiet. Be serious, as if you are really hurt. And after 5 minutes, he said, let's go. I had to go for the next function. It was a birthday party of a child. So when we were going, we came out, he was driving the car. He said, Swamiji, I think, because both of them were friends, some about 80 or so. He said, Swamiji, I think it is my number now. I said, please stop the car, let me get out. Be attentive. When you see or hear the news of anybody's death, and if you get this imagination, you are going to die, you are in virtual reality. Never were you born. Never do you grow. Never will you die. That is the real one. See, just correct your thinking. One couple, they were fighting and came for a solution. When the husband was defeated with the argument by the wife, he said, Swamiji, I simply told her, I am elder than you in age. Respect my age at least. You are insulting me all the time. Swamiji, you tell her. I said, I agree with her, not with you. You always do like that. I said, yes, Mama gives me food, you don't give me food. I had to take her side. Then I told, tell me how many years you are married? Swamiji, we are married for 15 years. So, your age is only 15 years. Who is fighting with each other? Man and woman or husband and wife? Husband and wife are fighting. So, the number of married life you are having, if it is 15 years you are married, your age as a husband and your age as a wife is only 15 years. So, for all practical purposes, you are a teenager. And teenagers are bound to fight with each other. Then what is to be done? Continue for another 4 years. Till you become 19. Once you cross 19 years of your married life and 20 years onward, then you will come to know a known enemy is better than an unknown friend. And then you continue. Come to realize this. We all get miserable only when we take the virtual reality as the actual reality. You are divine. Discover this. And when you are able to divide and discover this divinity, then you will see life is a great fun. And don't we like somebody who is happy? When somebody is happy, we like. What a joy it will be if you are happy. And happy doesn't mean all the time laughing, what happened happy? No, that is not happy. That is being a member of a laughing club. Have you seen the laughing club? Do you have here? Laughing club people are the dumbest people in the world. In their whole life, they never laughed. And in the old age, they regret. Oh God, whole life I never laughed. So let us go and join the laughing club. And then they stand around. And in that teacher, they have to teach how to laugh. Because whole life they did not laugh. Such people, if you want to see, go to Japan. I was in Tokyo for 15 days. I have taken a vow, I will never go. For 15 days, I have not seen one single face with a smile. All of them, like, you know, the statues. Like, as if I am talking to furniture. Simply sitting like this. I asked them, are you in meditation? Do you understand? Finally I say, I give up. See, friends. So such people, they want to learn how to laugh in the old days. That is not being happy. Be attentive. Actual reality that we are is essential bliss. What we are doing in our life, we are seeking happiness. Don't seek happiness. See? All that we do in our life is for seeking happiness. For example, one person observes fast. For what? Seeking happiness. The other person eats a lot up to the nose level. For what? For getting happiness. One person keeps on walking. For what? For getting happiness. Other person, like a potato couch, sits over there for happiness. In short, one person gets married for happiness, other person gets divorced for happiness. To summarize, all our involvement in life and all our withdrawal from the life is aimed at seeking happiness. Stop this business. And instead of seeking happiness, express happiness. Life is expressed through three channels. Our body, our speech, our mind. So express happiness through these three channels. Through the body, how to express happiness? Whatever action you do through the body, do it happily. When you are walking, walk happily. A person who walks happily, he walks straight and so cheerful and happy. Otherwise, we simply walk like a buffalo. Bhatak, 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 bhatak. Hey, where are you going? I don't know, yaar, I'm just going. Hare Ram, 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 Ram. See? If you have to do anything, that must bear a signature of your happiness on that action. See? When the South Indian girl gets married to a North Indian boy, South Indian means what? Idli. You are, most of you are South Indians, you know, they make the huge batter. First day it is idli. Then batter is made for 1 week. Then second day out of the same batter uttapam, flattened idli. The third day out of the same leftover batter it is a masala dosa. The fourth day out of the same batter it is a paper dosa. Only thickness is reducing, contents are the same. See? But when they go to North India, for everything they have got a chapati. They have got a chapati. So like in South India, if they have nothing to pull on to sleep, they will make a dosa and sleep with it. Similarly, in the North India, if they want anything to cover themselves, they make a chapati and cover. So much at ease. Now this South Indian girl, she got married and went to North India. And there she has to learn how to make chapati. First she started making, first chapati became South Island of New Zealand. Why this reason like this? After a few days, it became Japan, it became Indonesia. With great difficulty, it became Australia. And every time she has to prepare chapati, she is biting her teeth. Oh God, can't these people eat anything else all the time chapati? When she is making chapatis in a disgusted mode, frustrated, in that house, everybody will have constipation. Because she is not doing it happily. See, this principle I discovered. Somebody's house I went for food, very lovely food we enjoyed. So as I usually say, Annadata Sukhi Bhava, may you give me wonderful food every time I come to your house. This was my blessing. After I said this thing, the husband also said, may God bless you, give me also sometime good food like this. Then he said, Swamiji, you should stay in our house. I said, why? Then I will get good food every day. Otherwise, what food I get? You know the modern houses? You know WWW? In modern houses, it is FFF. Fresh from fridge. It comes out of the fridge. It is freshly had taken out from the fridge. And then it goes into the microwave. And comes out as a pindadan, and they give it to you. Horrible food. See, friends, anything you do, do it cheerfully, happily. I say, look here, when your wife is cooking for me, she is not cooking it as a duty. She is not cooking it as a burden. She is cooking this food. Oh, family is coming. I'm so happy. So every action of hers is adding and condiment of happiness in everything she has done. Therefore it is so tasty. Otherwise the ingredients are the same. Apply this principle in life. Anything that you do, that must bear your signature of happiness. When you go to bathroom, clean yourself, dress yourself properly, and you don't come out of the bathroom unless you wear a smile on your face. See, the life will be beautiful. How you dress and how you address tells the quality of your life. See, friends, that is expressing happiness through action. Always be neatly dressed, not somehow changing the banyans 3-4 times, this way, that way. No. At least, you know, here I know, Kerala is very good for that. I like the Kerala temples very much. Early morning you go, Gurayur for example, go any temple in Kerala early morning, the ladies come, nicely clean bath, fresh clothes, beautiful flowers, and smile on their face. Such gods are happy. If you go to the North India, they are becoming horrible. Bath, I have taken day for a study only. Why to take today also? Hurry. The clothes are not proper. No. Anything we do must express joy and happiness. Number one. Number two, we express through speech. When we express through speech, let us speak happily. Not bitterness, not anger. You must have seen there are some people, they don't talk, they bark. Why you have come here? Why you are standing there? Go there. Walk, walk, walk. See, you are a human being, don't bark. See, Bhagavad Gita says, Anudvega karam vakyam satyam priya hitam chayat. We must talk in such a manner that we are able to invoke positivity in the hearts of the listener. That is expressing happiness through speech. And the third, at the mind level, expressing happiness through mind is living at zero complaint level. No complaint about anything, no complaint about anybody, no complaint about any issue in life. You are thinking happily. You are talking happily. You are living and expressing every expression of life happily. And when happiness becomes a natural expression of your life, you are living in the actual reality. And whenever we are miserable, we are living in the virtual reality. So the journey of life is, we start from the virtual reality and we end up in the actual reality. And for this, we have got the choice. And the choice is, learn to remain in the utter present. Don't dig the graveyards of the past. Learn to forget. Don't remember. Forgetting the things is the God's gift. Those who cannot forget, they suffer throughout life. And those who forget, they are always happy. Take money from somebody and forget. You'll be so happy. That fellow will suffer. Oh, did I take? I don't remember. See, friends. And whenever you are happy, you are in tune with the divine, the actual reality. And whenever you are miserable, you are buried in the virtual reality. And what is the virtual reality? It doesn't exist. And yet we are miserable. See, friends. This is what is the real meaning of life. So when you are studying here as students, do your job perfectly well, earn grades and be very successful. After you go from here, whatever job or business you do, do it perfectly well, be successful in life. At the same time, do not disconnect yourself from the actual reality that you are. The complete success of life is external prosperity and inner poise. When external prosperity doesn't disturb the inner poise, then alone life is fully lived. And this is the choice for every one of us. Choose correctly and be happy. Nobody can make you happy. And you should never try to make anybody happy. But people say we should make others happy. No, I am not in favor of that. Don't make anybody happy. Why? Because we belong to a democratic setup, is it not? Everybody has a right to be miserable. This I learned from one taxi fellow. My friend was driving the car behind a taxi and he told, Swamiji, see that taxi fellow's door is open. He may fall. So I will take the car parallel to him. And down the glass, you tell him to close it. So whatever people tell, I have to obey. I am an obedient servant. So he took the car parallel to the taxi and he said, Swamiji, now you can tell him. So I told him, I said, hey Mahatmaji, your door is open, please close it. Who asked you? Mind your business. He's right. So my friend got a, see Swamiji, how rubbish that man is. I said, no, he's not, he's right, he's my guru. Don't get involved in anybody's life unless invited. Don't try to make anybody happy. I want to be miserable. Who are you to make me happy? Okay, Baba, continue. Second thing, you don't have to make anybody miserable. Everybody is self-sufficient. We don't have to contribute. And thus, come back to yourself. That is the actual reality. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnaat Purnamudachate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om.